And as you see, trading is, you don't need to be a full-time trader. You know what a full-time trader is? A full-time trader is not someone that trades all the time. This is not like a 9-to-5, guys. Full-time trader just means this. You're able to be there to look for your opportunities. And look at Alex. I consider him a full-time trader, but he only trades the first hour of the day, and he's gone. He's completely gone after the first hour. He's nowhere to be found. You know, that's a full-time trader. He does his business and he leaves. Doesn't mean that you cannot have more than one job, more than one occupation. The key is, man, like we have Tom, our moderator. It's a great example. He has $700. And so he needed to provide for his family all that. So he drove an Uber at night, which afforded him, he started saving little by little. So he grew that $700 account, guys, to six figures, you know? And now he's a freaking, he's a monster, you know? You're doing the right way, process everything. Once again, guys, you do not need to do this 24 hours a day. I do this to educate members. I'd rather just fucking nail and bail and leave right now. But I love trading so much, I use that as an excuse. But to be honest, you know, that gets me in trouble as well. But, you know, my job is MIC, guys. It's not really my job. I love doing this. I educate because I love educating, right? But that's what it is. I don't just sit around and I trade all day long. That's called overtrading. But I'm there educating members. So I'm looking at the markets. I'm showing them, you know, what I know. Because I'm telling you, man, at the end of the day, I'm an old man now. Who knows what the hell is going to happen? I would love to leave a legacy. And that's how you leave legacies. And so if you, through your education, you can teach your kids, you can teach whatever, guys. You know, this is... When I was in, I was an engineer. I was a software guy working in the .com Silicon Valley. And no one knew anything about stocks, man. If I knew about stocks, I would have fucking went for the stock options, cashed out, and became a fucking rich guy by the time I was 22 years old. But who the fuck tells a kid who grew up in poverty from the ghetto what the hell a stock was? Stocks were only for guys in fucking suits, white guys, albeit back then in suits. On Wall Street, right? What the hell is this little Asian kid know anything about stocks? So I made it a point to educate people now. And so now you all understand, so stocks everywhere now because of Robinhood and all that stuff. But they cater to the gamblers because sports was down and everyone was gambling. And they treated day trading like gambling. And you know what happened? The ones that were educated took all the money from the educated people. So the stimulus checks from the coronavirus went into their Robinhood accounts and then went into mine and Alex's account. It wasn't a direct transfer, but it was a transfer of funds from the uneducated to my pockets. The guys that were chasing. So for the longest time, a lot of these pump and dump rooms were doing things like buying the breakout, pumping and dumping, and I was just sitting there collecting money. Now they all changed their trading. They changed it. You know, because they're learning. Everybody learns. And you know what, man? I'm not going to say shit, but they're learning from MIC. Because we see it. We see it. They're using the same terms as us. They even have the chat room open and we see them. But it's all good. So if everybody is evolving. Everybody's getting better, guys. You know? If you not adapt, you will fucking not succeed. You know, you cannot be complacent. So that gets me to what I want to talk about today. So today, a couple items, guys. I see 100 person here. Who here is not taking advantage of the free trial? If you're not in MIC, we opened it up for just another couple of days more, guys. This is it. We're not going to have another free trial for, I don't know, if ever or a long ass time. We decided to do this for Black Friday because all these guys were selling all these packages and DVDs and all this stupid shit, and we're like, fuck that shit. Come and check out what the real mentorship program looks like, and don't fall for those traps. Okay, once you go to MIC, you'll see the difference between us and everybody else. And so whoever here, you know, is not part of MIC or who has not taken advantage of this 3-day free trial, I understand why you're not. You know, I understand maybe you just like to look at my ugly face all day, but that's cool too. But you know, sometimes, you know, you the opportunity comes knocking, you answer the door, guys. So we have a few days left. Also, I tweeted, like, we're giving away five people, $100 each. I'm not bullshitting about this. We're going to just randomly pick someone, five people today, during Tosh's webinar, guys. Tosh's webinar is at 2 p.m. market time. It's on our YouTube channel. It's YouTube Live, My Investing Club. If you have to ask, where is your YouTube channel? You should not be trading, to be honest. I'm going to stop giving out these links anymore because I'm like, hey, it's on our YouTube channel. And then if anybody messages me, where's your YouTube channel? I think you should just turn off your computer, walk into Walmart, become a hostess there, a greeter, and just say, hello, hello. I'm not putting those guys down, but you know what, man? Some people are not made to trade. You have to fucking be able to figure out where our YouTube channel is. I'll give you a little secret. It's the same fucking name as our name, My Investing Club. And there's a little tool that I figured out recently. This is a brand new tool that you can pretty much find anything you want. It's called Google. Try that, Google. Google, guys. So one of the dumbest questions I love is like, hey guys, hey man, how much is your service? Go to the website. What's your website? My website is youredumbass.com. I don't know what else to say. I think I'm just going to help people save their money. If anybody asks me, what's your website? I'm just going to say, trading's not for you, brother. Why don't you wire me 50% of how much you're about to lose in the markets? And at least you'll save 50%. So if you have $1,000 to waste on the markets, just strip me over $500 and you'll leave $500 richer than you would if you enter the markets. So that's one thing I'll talk about. I want to talk about, guys, if you want some shit in life, you fucking go and get it. No one's going to hand you anything. We've handed you enough. We handed you a 3-day free trial. And many of you have not taken advantage of that. I'm not going to fucking sit around and answer these fucking questions unless, you know, you have to take responsibility yourself, okay? So come to today's webinar with Tosh. Maybe make $100, who knows? I'm gonna tweet it again. I did this for fun because I saw some guy on Instagram say, you know, tag three friends. He's giving away whatever. I said, fuck it, we're gonna give away $100 to five people and see what happens. And surprisingly, only like 30 people did that. So you have a pretty fucking good chance of winning $100, guys. Only 30 people or so did that. Okay? So if we're gonna choose 5 out of 30 people, or 5 out of 50 people, that's a 10% chance you win $100 just by showing up today and on the webinar, okay? So go and find my Twitter. It's actually on My Investing Club's Instagram account. How to fucking qualify for $100. Because we're going to randomly pick people. And if you didn't follow the steps, I don't know what to tell you. $100, man. 5 people will get $100. Shit, if no one does it, I'll keep the $500. But... so today, I did something I never do. I posted my entire account just to show you. So today, we traded small accounts just to show you what's possible with the MIC process. People are trading with these million-dollar accounts, and then they're trying to teach you how they trade. Do you have a million-dollar account? There's no fucking way you can replicate what they're doing, guys. They're down fucking hundreds of thousands of dollars, and they're holding. How the fuck can you go through a fucking 80% drawdown on your account? You just cannot do that. It's just not the way to fucking make money, guys. Revenge trading, all that shit. So I just posted my accounts with account sizes that I use to create, to make what I make. This week, I'm going to reset all those fucking accounts. Go back to the same thing. We reset every week. Take the money out. We always tell each other, tell one another to pay yourself. Because what happens is this, I'll give you a very good secret, which I said all the time. If you have too much money just laying in there, you always think cushion money. Oh, I'm up all this money this year. It's a house money. Ain't no fucking house money, it's your money. You worked hard for that money. Why the hell are you gonna give it away? If you did not have that cushion, you wouldn't be taking these gambling trades. You're loosey-goosey because you have cushion. And that's the wrong way to trade. Discipline is how you become successful in life. Every successful individual has discipline, guys. What is the common denominator in everybody who's successful? It's not because they're the smartest or the best looking. It helps, but that's not the common denominator, okay? It's discipline. Everybody who's successful has a routine. It's not by luck, okay? Sure, there is luck, but they have a great line for that. The more you practice, the harder you work, the luckier you get. It's a funny thing, right, guys? It's a funny thing. The harder you work, the luckier you get. So luck is when opportunity, what's that saying, man? It's when, well, you get the idea, right? You make your own fucking luck, guys, in life. And I keep telling you guys, man, you don't fall in love with these giant P&Ls from these big traders. Because how is that going to help you? Learn the process. Learn the fucking process. They won't tell you the process because they have no process. Their process is just a short, the giant shit. And bank, 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 bank. How the fuck is that going to help you? And so that's why we opened up MIC, guys, for 3 days. To show you the fucking process. Okay, and that's why Alex and I tweeted P&Ls. Just to show you the process. And these are not giant accounts we're training with. These are not $1 million accounts, guys. These are standard accounts that you all have. Well, many of you have, right? It's a normal account. You know, look on that Twitter I posted today. I mean, those are the realistic numbers you can do pretty much every day. If you work your ass off. If you're disciplined. I'm not disciplined every day. I was disciplined today. That's why I produced those numbers. See, I want to tell you the thing. I hardly ever lose, knock on wood, if I follow my process. And if I follow my process and I lose, I am okay with it. It's a small, manageable loss. The big losses come when I break and I deviate from my process. And then I start to use the cushion game. That's why my tab Alex helps me all the time. He's like, Bow, get the fuck out. Do these walks. Because he knows me, man. I have a cushion. And the money doesn't really mean much to me. I like to trade. I like to feel that excitement. But that's the wrong way to do it. I tweet all the time that when I was young, I wanted the action. Now I just want a boring ass job that makes me money 1 hour a day. That's what trading is. You know, I love to educate, and so that's why I stick around, guys. So I'm telling you, the secret to success is consistency, routine, hard work, humility, being humble. There's a huge difference between being arrogant and confident. You can totally tell when a dick is arrogant. And there's two types of people in the world, guys. Someone that is humble or someone that's about to get humbled. And trust me, man, we've all been on that side where we think we're the hot shit, and then life humbles the fuck out of us. I've been there. I don't want to be there again. So that's what we call risk management. You have risk management in your life, like auto insurance, things like that, health insurance. Those are risk management. You gotta say fucking YOLO. I'm not gonna put a stop loss on my life. You know what a stop loss is? Just seatbelt you put in your car. And another stop loss is a fucking car insurance. Some shit happens, you know. And another stop loss is your health insurance in case you crash. So don't fucking listen to these motherfuckers who called risk management training wheels. Fuck that shit. Everybody, including billion-dollar traders, have stop losses. They have fucking max losses that they do not want to go over. You know why you have to have a max loss, guys? It's because when you hit a certain point of losses, your brain, it's all fucked up. You can't think straight. You will start to revenge trade because you're so desperate to make it back. Because what happens when you lose so much, you're like, fuck it. I'd rather lose it all now. And then when you lose it all, you're like, fuck, I should have stopped. You know, that's how it starts, man. So you start by, you know, like you could have taken a 10% loss, for example. Fuck, I'm going to let it ride. 20% loss, fuck, now it's starting to hurt a little bit. I'll let it ride. And then when it hits 50%, you're like, fuck, I should have stopped out. And then I'm like, fuck, 50%, fuck it, I lost too much money. I'm gonna go all in. Do or die. And then it drops again. Now you're 75% loss. And you wish you'd just taken that 50% loss. There's a point of no return. And that's why you always need to have a tab, a trading accountability buddy. Everybody on Wall Street has what's called a risk compliance officer. He's gonna stop you out, man. He's not gonna let you fucking short Tesla and make the firm go broke. He's gonna stop your ass out. You tell me those guys need training wheels? The guys are training $1 billion at Goldman Sachs Everybody has a fucking risk compliance officer on them. We do not. That's why we need stop losses. We need broker side max losses. We need train accountability buddies to have all that. So I'm telling you, man, I'm going to tweet again the link. The aha moment that made me successful as a day trader. I was a very, very, very consistent trader. Very consistent. I hardly ever lost. But when I lose, it's a giant ass motherfucking loss that wipes away months of work. So you can be consistent, but not profitable. That's one thing people do not understand. Consistency and profitability are not one and the same. You can be consistent, 99% win rate, but that 1% lose rate can bankrupt you. Okay, guys? So don't look at these guys. Win rates mean absolutely shit. It's your losses. How much do you lose? That 1% that you lose. That is the aha moment that made me a successful trader. When I was like, fuck, dude, I was such a good trader. Every day I'm up. But I just can't control myself when I lose. I never knew about stop losses. I never knew about max loss set on the broker level. So imagine on a $1 million account, if I just had a $30,000 loss, max loss on the fucking my account, you'd be fine. If you had a $50,000 account, if you had a $5,000 stop loss, you'd be fine. You'll never blow up, knock on wood. Okay, because sometimes you just need someone to slap you. What the fuck are you doing, dude? You're fucking fighting this motherfucking stock and you're wrong. Get the fuck out. So risk management, guys, is the fucking key. Don't be impressed by win rates. Look at how much they're losing. Because you know what, man? They've been working for years. You just started trading. You cannot do what they do. You have to learn the right way to trade, guys. You have to fucking learn the way that gets you there. Because you're not going to make it to the first year if you have no risk management. And that's why we are walking around talking about people all this shit. And I'm telling you, a lot of people say, hey, you're giving away too many secrets. How can your shit work if all these people know? I've been preaching this shit for 10 years and people still don't fucking listen. You can have the best strategies in the world, but people fuck up because they have FOMO. They have no risk control. They have greed. They don't take their gains. There's a lot of reasons why, man, there's a formula to get rich. You know that. Don't fucking spend your money. Save your money. But people don't do that shit. It's not how much you make, guys, how much you save, okay? My parents fucking came from poverty, had $0 in the bank, and they became a millionaire by saving. It took them a long ass time, saving and proper investment in real estate, whatever the hell it may be. But that's the thing, guys. You can have the best strategies, but you know what? Having the best strategies is a huge, huge leg up. Because now you're not going down the wrong rabbit hole. When I started trading, man, I didn't know where the fuck to look. I tried all sorts of fucking strategies. Dude, I did earnings plays. You know what got me hooked into day trading? I gambled on earnings and I thought I was the shits because my first trade ever was Silicon Graphics and it was up 33% on earnings. And I was like, yeah, motherfucker, I cracked the code. This shit is so easy. And I started winning these earnings trades and then when I won, I was like, fuck, I won 3 in a row. I'm the fucking king. I should start a subscription service. I'm gonna fucking be the man after 3 wins in a row, right? And you know what creeped in my head? Fuck, why didn't I go all in? I'm a dumbass. This is so obvious. Oh my God, next one I'm gonna go all in. And you know what happened? Next one I went all in, I went broke. That's the shit that's always the shit that works, man. So all these guys, I got fucking, you know, everybody now is a fucking guru, dude. I just started trading. I'm gonna fucking start a service. I'm the fucking best. Well, fuck it, man. I've seen those guys come and go. And I'm telling you, man. Honestly, I said this in the other webinar before. This is how you know someone's a fraud or not. Very simply. Can they walk around in public and not get beat up? If you have to fucking hide, you're hiding something. Okay? We are here doing meetups. I'm not fucking scared. No one's gonna jump me because I help everybody. In fact, they help me. They defend me if someone jumps me. Whereas, like, dude, I don't see anybody fucking walking around the streets. Seriously, that's it. So I live my life with integrity. I don't fuck anybody. And the people, this is the thing that's fucked up, because people go, they don't believe it. You don't have to fucking believe it, motherfucker. You can go on your merry little way and fucking continue your whole life. But why do you keep trolling me for years and still don't believe me? You know, secretly they're fucking in love with me, but I don't want to talk about that anymore. But, you know, but if you don't get trolled, you must be fucking doing something wrong, right? I don't know. I don't like to get trolled, and sometimes I get trolled because it's on me. I'm too arrogant. So as you see, you know, I've reduced my arrogance over the years as well. I'm still learning every day, guys. Every day is a progress for me to learn new things. And, you know, this is part of being the humble part. I'm trying to, you know, I realize I don't know everything in life and I need help. So I've been asking for help, and that's why we're doing well. You can't do everything yourself, you know. I got help to be able to walk out here and exercise. Alex helps me. He's like, get the fuck out, pal. I would be there training all the time. It's like, and you become a nervous wreck, you know. It's like, this is the thing with trading, guys. It's like, if you stick around long enough and you have cushion, you will bleed it all away. Let's say you're up $5,000 and you bleed $500 a day, $1,000 a day. You're still up $4,000 a day. That's $1 million a year. I'll take it. But imagine you bled $1,000 a day. All stupid shit because you have cushion. That's $5,000 a week. That's $20,000 a year. I mean, a month. That's a quarter of a million a year you just bled away. Even $100 bleeding a day is huge. $100. I could buy whatever fucking lunch I want. I'm going to the fucking outlet mall because I'm told cheap to buy clothes regular price. And here I am bleeding $1,000 because I'm up. I have cushion. And then in real life, I'm like, holy fuck. And that's why Alex keeps a stack of dollar bills to remind himself how much money is. Imagine if we were trading, not numbers on the screen, but actual $20 bills. And you see how many fucking $20 bills you're fucking wasting or winning. You shit yourself. Like, what the fuck? You know? That's why casinos give you chips. Because a $100 chip looks like a dollar chip. But if you saw that shit in a stack, I'll be like, whoa, I'm not gonna fucking gamble my fucking shit. Why am I betting a $1,000 hand on blackjack? I have a fucking 12. You know, I have a fucking 16. But we do that in trading. Because it's, you know, oh, there's a shot. There's a chance. If I have a 16, I'll pull a 5 and hit 21. And that's why you die, guys. And so I wanted to remind you guys, because this is Thanksgiving. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. You know, each year we count our blessings. I'm just blessed to be fucking healthy and alive and to be able to do what I love and help people. So go down, sit down, and think about what you're blessed for. Don't think about the things that you're missing this year. So what if you fucking couldn't travel? So what if you didn't fucking make $1 million? So what? You're like, you have food on the table, you're healthy, you're still alive. I have friends that were hurt by the coronavirus. I'll survive. So I'm very thankful just for that, guys. So one major thing before I leave, the attitude is everything. Always think positive, because you know what, man? There's no reason to be negative. Always, life is about this. Either you win or you learn. Or you go broke. There's only three options. I choose to learn. Humble yourself, learn from all your mistakes, or you're gonna go broke. All right, guys, and with that, happy Thanksgiving. Today at 2 p.m., Tosh's webinar. Free trial. Black Friday ends this Friday, so you better get on the board right now, guys. And tomorrow, the market is closed. And Friday is a half day, so it's over. So jump into the free trial today, because otherwise, I don't know what else is left for you guys. The market's gonna be closed. And we'll see you today, 2 p.m., Tosh's webinar. And I will tweet out some stuff. Check out my Twitter about the $100 giveaway. Thanks, guys. Happy Thanksgiving.